Hey y'all, and welcome back to my channel. Today's video, I'm going to show you my kitchen transformation. My husband and I have been working on our kitchen cabinets for the past 3 days. That is how long it took for us to paint and seal them. And also, I'm just going to give you a few tips along the way. If you have never painted your kitchen cabinets before, or if you have never used chalk paint, because that's what we used, then I just want to give you a few tips in case that is something you're interested in. So if that's something that you want to see, then go ahead and keep watching. So if you have watched any of my painting projects before, then you know I love to use chalk paint. And for this one, I decided to go with the Rust-Oleum chalk paint. We got this from Home Depot. My husband was actually so extremely sweet. He woke up early one morning and he headed out to Home Depot and he spent his Christmas Home Depot gift card. I did not ask him to do it. He did it for me and I was so excited. I have been wanting to paint these kitchen cabinets forever, pretty much ever since we moved into the house, which was about 4 months ago. And so yeah, I decided to go with the Rust-Oleum because it was the cheapest chalk paint that I could find. We had looked at Home Depot, Lowe's, and Amazon. So this was the cheapest. There's others to choose from. I believe it's pronounced Valspar. And then of course there's Annie Sloan chalk paint, which is probably the most expensive. I've also used another one that I found, I think it was either at Walmart or on Amazon, and it was an eco-friendly paint. That's the one that I chose to use for my dining room table and chairs. Also, I had to paint everything, pretty much 3 coats. I basically did 2 full coats, and then I went back and I touched up on spaces that looked bare and that you could still see a little bit of the wood shining through. So here I'm going to also give you some tips. I have painted several projects, including another set of kitchen cabinets back when we lived in Florida. I've painted my dining room table. I've painted a few pieces of furniture here and there, and I feel like I know a little bit about chalk paint. So the first thing I'm going to share with you, first of all, if you have never used chalk paint before, this is tip number one, is that you do not have to sand. The only time you would need to do any type of prep work is if it is bare wood, and that might be just to use some type of primer, and that's only because the chalk paint will soak into the bare wood very quickly, so it will take you several coats just to cover it. So that's pretty much the only type of prep work that you might need to do when using chalk paint. It's fine if you're painting over almost any type of material, whether that's wood or metal or glass or anything like that. Chalk paint is very forgiving also. So you can paint in any direction you want and it pretty much looks good no matter what. So the second tip I'm going to give you is to use a chalk paint brush. I have used chalk paint brushes and I've also used just a regular standard paintbrush, and they work completely different. The chalk paint brush is actually meant for chalk paint. It has several bristles, and it actually is more natural. The ones that I've used are a natural bristle brush. So when you're using the artificial ones, it doesn't soak up and grab enough of the paint, and it also causes you to drip and make a bigger mess. So here are the cabinet doors after I have pretty much finished painting them. I have done 2 coats and then an additional touch-up coat. So we had them all over. This is our garage. They were also in our homeschool room. At first, I was not going to distress them, but we made a mistake and used wax at first as our sealer, and then we discovered that that is not durable enough. So that's my third tip, is to not use wax. People will tell you to use wax. Do not use wax. Use some type of water-based sealer, and this is the one that I went with, and I got this tip from Lindsay Domer. Her channel is Domer Home. I will actually link her above and below so you guys can go check her out. She does a lot of crafts and she's amazing. So do not use wax over chalk paint for things such as kitchen cabinets or dining room tables or anything that's going to have a lot of high traffic. I think it would be fine for something like a dresser or a headboard or something like that, as long as you're not putting any type of moisture or anything like that that would ruin it, whether it's like essential oils or a glass that might have condensation, anything that you're planning on doing that, I just would not use wax. It's just not as durable. So this right here is at my bar, and at first I was actually going to paint this gray because I do have some gray chalk paint, but I'm so glad that I decided to go with the white. It really made everything look polished and just finished and perfect. I love the way that it turned out. So it did take me a pretty much full 3 coats for this one because I don't know what was different about it. I guess the wood is a little bit different than the actual kitchen cabinets themselves. But yeah, so that was my third tip as far as the sealer. Definitely go with that. Also, you want to at least do 2 coats. I ended up doing 3 coats of the sealer just because I know how rough and tough we are with our kitchen cabinet doors and drawers and everything. So if you feel like you need that extra protection, then I would definitely go with a 3rd coat of the sealer. It also didn't turn the wood yellow, but in places that it built up, it did have like little droplets of yellow, and you'll see that in just a little bit. And right here, this is my last tip. I've seen a lot of people and they will wrap it either in saran wrap or press and seal. I like to use a freezer bag. I feel that it is it has a better seal basically. So I just use the brushes and for 3 days I put them in the bag and voila. So here it is. Here's what my kitchen looks like. I'm so excited. Every time I walk in there now, I feel like it is a completely different kitchen. I'm so in love with it. I'm so glad that we decided to distress because I know that it's just going to get little nicks here and there and it's going to take away from it. So I'm glad that we decided to distress. So if you have any questions about anything, then please feel free to leave me a comment down below. I forgot to mention that there is a little bit of prep work whenever you are painting anything, and that is always wipe down whatever it is that you are painting. You don't want any dust or anything like that to get in with your paint. It will make things bumpy. Also, be sure to use painter's tape no matter how good of a painter you think you are. It's always good just to be careful and to use the painter's tape. I like the green kind. I believe the brand is Frog Tape or something like that. I think it works really well. My husband actually picked it out. We've used it before and I like the way that it works. Also, for the clear sealer, I got this tip also from Lindsay Domer, and she recommended using the sponge brushes. They're super cheap. I got a bag of, I think it was like 9 or 10 for $2.50 from Home Depot or Lowe's. So yeah, this was a pretty inexpensive project. I also forgot to mention, I forgot to mention a lot, but we ended up using 2 of the, I believe it was 30-ounce cans of paint for this project, and it painted everything. I had just a little bit of paint left over in one of them whenever I was finished. So if you guys enjoyed watching this, then please leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you think. And if you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new. I love to make cleaning motivation videos. I love to help inspire and motivate other mothers and women out there to clean their homes because I know I myself need motivation. So if that's something you're into, then definitely hit that subscribe button. I hope you all have a blessed and wonderful day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.